Good morning, it's Lori Atkins-Williamson, and I'm just going to go through an early morning practice with you. We'll start with meditation. If you would like to go ahead and get set up. You can sit any way that's comfortable, and then you'll want to really just become present with your seat. And take a few big breaths. Attention to the connection of your seat, legs, feet to the earth. And the connection of your own body parts to one another, the back of the shins touching the thighs, the weight of the arms resting against your body, hands that are resting on your thighs and your lap, or touching. And just really like notice these parts of your body. Attention to the base of the spine, the pelvis. It creates some adjustments, some lifting from the front of the pelvis, the center of the pelvis, allow the tailbone to descend and support you. And from the structure of the pelvis, you can lift your spine up. Pull your shoulders back, expanding the chest. And bring your attention to the head. And we'll create a lift from the top of the skull. The asana of meditation has been created. You bring all of your attention to your breath. It's just a natural breath in and out. When you put your attention on the breath, it may change the quality slightly, the depth. Meditation, there's not able to necessarily control the breath, just to be aware of it. The structure has been set. When the breath realizes, you just sit. You breathe in. distraction is an issue, you bring your mind back to your body, where it touches the earth, how it touches other parts. You recommit to your strength and lift in your spine, ease in the face and the jaw, connection of your hands to each other or your lap. And breathe easy. Your meditation, your sitting in stillness, is a tool for getting present, a tool for awakening. And you do that by really acknowledging being in your body and in space. Sensing what you sense, focusing your attention on the things that are real. Take your attention off the things that are thoughts. Close your forehead. Namaste. And move with the child's pose. And then moving to child's pose, we will expand breath into Ujjayi style breath. It's a full diaphragmatic breath. Bringing the air in through your nose, throat, bronchi, lungs, and back out. Often Ujjayi breath is audible. With Ujjayi breath, you will use the back of the throat to control how the volume goes in and out. So you lengthen the breath by pulling it in with a little bit of constriction in the back of the throat, and you exhale the same way. It's a shift from a gasp to a long controlled breath. Down dog. We're going to move through the journey into power practice. Moving from integration to awakening, or integration now. The first down dog. Allowing the breath to move and shift your energy. Foundation here is hands, feet, and the pelvis. As the pelvis is the foundation, so does the shoulder girdle. You press through the hands and you're squeezing the arm muscles into the bones and lifting the arms up, creating some space in upper back and chest. And you do the same with your legs. You press down in the feet, squeeze up on the thighs, press out with the feet, engage the glutes, make more space in the sacrum and the low back. Ragdoll. Ragdoll has relaxed upper body, energized lower body. Half lift, heel toe your feet in where you like to move from. I like my narrow pelvis width. Lengthen the spine. And then fold, and really, as you're folding, like look at your feet, separate the toes, press into the mounds, the front mound, the back mound of your foot, the heel. And then rise up to mountain, extended. Hands to the chest. Om, breath in. Inhale, look up. Fold forward, exhale. Lengthen your spine. Downward facing dog. In breath. Out breath, step to your hands. Lengthen your spine. Fold. Extended mountain. Fold forward. Lengthen your spine. Set your drishti down. That's your visual focus. Keep the drishti set. Go back to low push-up, nice and easy. Up dog. Now your drishti is forward, visual focus forward. Downward facing dog, this is the exhale, your drishti is set back of your mat. Breathe in. And breathe out, step forward. lengthen, fold, all the way up, all the way down. Halfway lift, set the drishti, chaturanga, up dog, down dog, in, out, step forward, lengthen, fold, extended mountain, fold forward, connect each breath to the movement, lift and lengthen, and the dance of breath chaturanga, it's nice and smooth, up dog is the end, drishti forward, down dog out, visual focus back, inhale, exhale, step forward. Lengthen, fold, all the way up, all the way down, half lift, chaturanga, up dog, down dog, in, out, step forward. Lengthen, fold, all the way up, all the way down, lengthen, and then chaturanga. The pace is set by the length of the breath, up dog, down dog, breath in and out. You can hold your down dog, or you can do a forward breath handstand. If you're in headstand, you'll gently come down. Lengthen, fold, Utkatasana, keep with this pose is taking the seat low, lifting from the front pelvis, pressing out with your legs, and integrating your shoulders, so shoulders onto the back as you reach up, setting drishti, and you play with the balance of the pose, breathe in, fold forward, lengthen, chaturanga, up dog, down dog, warrior one, couple seconds to anchor in both feet, working both hips on the same plane, you drag it through the glutes, pressing through your feet, your heels, you start to use the glutes to square, lifting from the front. Breath in, chaturanga, up dog, down dog, left side, warrior one. And same thing, just a couple breaths, you're really pressing into the feet, using the heels to access glutes, and lifting from the front. And then chaturanga. Acknowledging that sides are different, right and left. You may have one that seems more cooperative than the other. Exhale, down dog. Breathe in. And breathe out. Step or jump forward. Lift and lengthen. And fold. We'll move through the rest on one breath. Chair. Letting the body warm. Fold. Lengthen. Chaturanga, up dog, down dog, right foot forward, warrior one, set your drishti, go up, chaturanga, keep your drishti set, up dog, down dog, left side where my shoulder right now. Up dog, ujjayi again. Down dog, ujjayi out. Inhale. Out breath, step or jump. Lengthen inhale. Fold out. Chair in. Fold out. Lengthen. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Warrior one, right leg forward. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Left side. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Step it up. Lengthen. And fold. Chair. Fold. Lengthen. Chaturanga. Up. Down dog. Warrior one. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Left side, warrior one. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Together and out. Step or jump. Lift and lengthen. Fold. Chair. Fold. Half lift. Chaturanga. Feel the magic of the breath and the dance. Up dog. Down dog. Right foot forward. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Left foot. Chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog. In. Out. Step it up. Lengthen. Fold. Chair. Fold. Half of that. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Warrior one, right foot forward. Go up and back. Open warrior two. Just pause. Your gesture can be straightforward, right? Or you can shift it over your front fingers. Reverse the warrior. Half moon. You can go into the suspended half moon. Or you can take your hand to the earth. Breathe in and out. Bend your standing leg, warrior two. Full inhale. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Left side, warrior one. Up and back. Warrior two. Take a second to settle in. So I've got all kinds of tiny hairs on my face. And breathe. Reverse the warrior. And then you slide in to half moon. The suspended one, this side's harder for me. I'll still try to work it, right? Because that's how we transform. Breathe in and out. Bend knee, go back, warrior two. Take a full inhale together. And then chaturanga. Every day I get a little better. Up dog. Downward facing dog. And it's not right or wrong if we can suspend that pose. It's just a challenge to balance. Right like that. Bend your knee, open your knee to the right, extend your leg. And breathe, to shift our body. And bend it again. Now you can go hip over hip, open it up. And then palm onto your left foot, bend your knee, and you're going to flip the dog. I will walk myself back on my mat and reach up. Right hand up, down dog. Side plank right arm down. Breathe in. And chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Left leg up. Bend your knee. You're going to turn your knee exactly to the left. So it's a complete abduction. Extend your left leg and breathe. Drishti set, back of the mat. Then bend it in, open hip over hip. And flip the dog. Ujjayi breath. Reach back up, down dog. Side plank, left arm down. I do it from down dog, it allows me to get my hips a little higher. I feel a little bit stronger in it. You can do it from plank if you prefer. Last inhale, and then chaturanga. Up dog. Downward facing dog, empty. Breathe in and breathe out. Step or drop forward. We'll lengthen and bow. Chair pose. I'm going to take a block between my shins. What it does for me is it gives me a target, pressing into the ball mounds of my feet. My inner ankles are kind of turning back, like there's this internal rotation in the lower bone, and then an abduction really in the upper bone, so it's like rolling down and out still. Reach up, twist right. Breathe all the way in. When you breathe out, just twist left. Stay low. Keep pulling both shoulders back. Seat low. Inhale and exhale. One more. Empty it out. Now one inhale. Fold forward. Exhale. Step your feet out. Big toe pose. Inhale. And bow. Ujjayi breath, eyes wide open. Your drishti is the back of your mat again. Hold your drishti, release your toes, walk your hands into your feet. Gorilla pose. Send your drishti to the front of your mat, half lift. And then pull yourself down, drishti to the back of the mat. Ujjayi breath. Release your feet and your hands from your feet. And this morning I'm going to opt for malasana. So you bring your feet together and you're going to come to the ball ends of your feet, but squat all the way down, knees out wide. So it looks kind of like that. I can show you from this side. It's like over the back. So the feet are together. You're on the ball mounts. Knees go out wide like that. And then what I'm going to do is from the front, I'll wrap my arms around and grab onto my heels and try to tuck in. And from the front. This is in lieu of the arm balance. Sometimes I need a little break on my hands and my arms. So it's a nice deep hip stretch, a little back stretch, and a place with a balance. Three, two, keep tucking, and one. Take your hands to the floor and walk your feet out to the athletic stance, half lift. Empty your air. And raise all the way up, extended mountain. Eagle pose, right side. Extended mountain. Eagle pose, left side. Extended mountain. So in eagle pose, you're wrapping your right arm under, lifting your shoulders up, and then I'm kind of taking a really high chair, wrapping my right leg over. My work is to pull in, seat down, shoulders back. See, the stability is not that easy today. More central, there it is. More central engagement and stabilizing. Three, two, and extending mountain. We'll do the left side. So there's some work in it, right? Shoulders back. Drishti is my elbows, inner eye. Squeezing, thigh over thigh. Shoulders back, tailbone down. Pressing firmly in my standing foot. Flexing my lifted foot. Three, two. Extended mountain. Hands to hips. Right leg up. Standing leg raise. I'm going to go with a bent knee today. You can extend if you'd like. You can extend. Grab the other edge of your foot. You can use a strap. Take it to the right. Really working to get long in the center. And your arm can go out, right? Or it can come by your side, palm forward. She can shift. Center, ujjayi breath in, reach. And ujjayi breath out, go to airplane. Take your time to integrate your shoulders. Hands to your heart, just pause. Keep your hands pressed to the heart, fold over your standing leg. Grab your ankle. One or both hands, pull yourself in the standing split. And then take your left hand out to a block or the floor. And start to peel yourself open to the second half moon of the practice. Driving your left hip under the right. Playing with the balance of the pose, adjust. Sugar cane for three. Two. Last breath in, and foot down, rise up mountain. Hands to your hips. Last side. You always want to be changing, you know, kind of adjusting and moving into what can improve your alignment, the sensations in your body. Discovering what you have to engage, where you can let go, where you need focus. Come back to center, reach up, airplane. Ujjayi breath. Hands to heart. Pause. Nothing's changing. And you hold your drishti, which will move as your head drops. Hold over your standing leg. If you can, grab your ankle, one or both hands. Start to pull yourself in for 3, 2, 1. Forgiving yourself if the balance is off. And then you'll open, right hand down, open in half moon. And I'm playing with and without my block this morning just to kind of sense what's different. So I'm just working the plain half moon right now, which is a strong pose. And then we'll go to sugar cane for about 3 breaths. You can start to bind it. And you may have to adjust, like where my block is, it's wobbly because it's half on the mat. So I'm gonna take it off so that it's stable. Last inhale. And then foot down, exhale. Mountain. We'll go to dancer, right side. I almost always use a strap for dancer. You don't have to. It keeps me stable. It helps me actually get into the pose, which otherwise would be difficult or inaccessible. And foot down, switch sides. Including transition, a total of about 5 to 7 breaths. Left side's more of a challenge. I have to really work to keep my hips square here. 2 more breaths. Last one. And then foot down right side. Anyway, acknowledging the differences in our body is kind of part of the process of being present with our body. Without really getting angry at the parts for not being able to balance the way we think they should, but just really acknowledging that there's a difference and work to be done everywhere. The work may just be different side to side. Ujjayi in, out, full expression, and switch sides. Expression. Last breath. And foot down. Move to tree pose. Right leg up. More about trying to get the hip square, less about where the knee actually goes. And once you get foot to thigh, really press in, kind of find that center line, and you're imagining that your hands are meeting at the center line, and you can feel the center line strength from that connection of foot to thigh. And sometimes when you find that, you can squeeze both glutes and you can get a little more abduction of the right leg. That means pulling out. One more breath. Foot down. Left leg. Still working for the same center line on this side. I almost always catch my right foot, not quite centered, so I'll make a quick adjustment here and there to get it centered and find the energy through the ball mound, big toe, center of my heel, driving, connecting in, shoulders back, and then give it to breath for three, two. Last breath in and out. Foot down. Extended mountain. Fold forward. Halfway lift. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Warrior one, right foot forward. Warrior two. Triangle pose. I'm going to reverse the warrior this morning, straighten my front leg, and then come in with a long right side. Use a block on the outside of your foot. Props are amazing. You should be able to order them almost anywhere at this point. Yoga blocks, a strap, a couple small sweat towels, a mat that you love. If 2020 has taught us anything, it is some resilience and also that we can do everything we need at home. We just need some tools. I'm hoping that my videos give you a tool or two, and then you can get your props. Strata fold, you'll rotate your feet in. I like to do a little back bend, push down on my glutes, go up and back, and then fold forward. Keeping it active by pressing into my feet, pull in. And gently, with a nice long flat spine up, turning my feet toward the front for pyramid. So, torso length, front to back, side to side, hip width. Do whatever you want with your hands. You can reverse namaste, which is a nice action. To get reverse namaste, you want to pull your shoulders up and back, and then your palms will get closer together. Inhale, exhale, fold. Chest towards your right leg, but not on your right leg. Three. Two. And one. You're going to drop your hands down. Take your left hand to the block. I go inside my right foot. If you're really mobile, you may be able to go outside. This allows me a deeper twist, able to keep my spine longer, a little more integrated in my pelvis. For three, two, drishti goes up, last breath, downward facing dog. Inhale, high plank, exhale, low, inhale, up dog, and then turn your toes back under, low plank, high plank, down dog. Left leg forward, warrior one. This is up and back, like you really enjoy warrior one. And then open to warrior two. And do your setup for your triangle. And then a couple breaths and go in. You're looking for 3 points on the earth. Left foot, right foot, left hand. Ears in line with your shoulders and then start to look up. Two more breaths.
Last one.
On this side, just come up, shift your feet for pyramid. Same or different arm bind, I'm gonna do the same one. It's actually a little bit of work for me to do the reverse namaste, so it's a good practice. Fold forward when you're ready. Really pressing into both feet. And drop your hands. Find your block. Right hand down this time. Lengthen the spine first. And then from the length, twist. Last breath. Down dog. Inhale, high plank. Lower 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And lay down on your mat. Take a full breath in and turn the other cheek. Into neutral, lift up and locust. You can choose your variation. I usually like my hands on the floor because it gives me a connection. Just breathe in and out. Flex your feet, turn your toes down. Lift up from the heels. Breathe in and drop down, exhale. Inhale, empty your air, pull the front of the pelvis up, open up, locust. Bend your knees, grab your ankles. Lift up, floor bow. One more breath. Go back to locust. Drop it down. Take your hands, kind of, I guess even with your shoulders, and press up into cobra. And then walk your hands back and go to up dog. Shoulders onto your back, press through the floor, lift up. Breathe. One. From the pelvis up. Thigh bones into the pelvis. Exhale, down dog. Knees down for camel pose. Straight from the side. I turn my toes under most of the time. Integrate the pelvis. Integrate shoulders, chin in line, and open up. You can take your hands right here to your glutes and press them down. Take your hands to your thighs, start to let your head and neck go back. Or if you want, you can reach your ankles. Two more breaths. Last one. Chin to chest, integrated spine up. Brief break, have a seat. That's where I usually get a drink. We'll do another camel. Knees right out of pelvis. Open up. 5, 4, 3, 2, chin to chest, come all the way up. You'll come straight to your back for bridge. I've placed a block between my ankles. I do that kind of as a check-in. I wanna kind of press down on my feet, and it allows me to get that action in my heels of pulling back a little bit. Walk my shoulders underneath. 5, squeeze seat, 4, 3, 2, and one all the way down. So in those poses, I'm not really counting breath, just a time so that you know when to come out. It's hard to watch a video while you're in the back bends. And then we're going to start in bridge. Press down in your feet, press down in your arms, lift up. You can stay in bridge or you can take your arms out and press down and take a wheel. 5, 4, 3, 2, and down. It's the only one today. Let your spine drop. And then draw your soles of your feet together, knees out for butterfly. And take a moment just to close your eyes. Or you can keep gazing at the whatever's above you, ceiling, sky. Bring your knees into the chest. We're gonna do a little bit of stability, flex feet, lifted to the ceiling. Release your hands behind your head and draw a little belly down. We're just going to do scissor legs. You're going to switch. So you curled up, switch, 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 switch. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Both legs up. Take your hands under your seat. Lower your legs 1/3 of the way. Chest is down. 2/3. And then hover. Now chest is up, chin to chest, and breathe. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Active feet, lift back up. One more of those. 1/3. 2/3. Hover, chin to chest. 5, 4. Active feet. 3, 2, and up. Bend your knees, 10 bicycles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Knees to chest. And then just gently and slowly rock up to boat pose, Navasana. I take my hands on the outer edges of my shins. I create like this resistance and kind of connects me and allows me to get a bigger reach. 5, 4, 3, 2, and legs down. You can go to down dog and supine half pigeon or seated half pigeon. So the down dog would be coming through. You can vinyasa that. So down dog with half pigeon set up, knee toward right elbow and drop in. Seated option looks like this. Right leg over. The supine felt pretty good to me this morning, so I'm going to start there. I don't really believe in holding these for a very long time. Probably 5 to 7 breaths. Just allow your body to create some opening without creating strain in the ligaments. Your drishti at this point can be where your eyes are naturally set, or you can close them. And then this morning, let's just switch sides. So go through down dog. And left leg, or opposite leg, if you started on the left. Okay, this time you'll gently press yourself up on whatever leg is behind you and bring it around. If you are in the seated version, you just drop into the double pigeon. I'm going to go double pigeon. And I create my setup. I get my sit bones firmly planted, and where my shins go are totally dependent on where my hips are. So I try to create as much squared offness as possible without having any sharp pain in the knee. No sharp pain really in the hip joint either. This, I feel like you should feel this mostly in the glutes, so like the back of the buttocks, maybe a little bit in the side. The deep pinches in the front are probably not great. If you feel those, I would probably try to engage or change it so that you don't feel those deep pinches in the front. And then we're just going to switch sides. Noticing differences from side to side, and do what you need to get the opening. Again, kind of along the back of the glutes. Try to get it a little bit out of the pinchiness in the front. I'm just doing a self-assist, actually. I'm pushing my left pelvis back as I'm pulling my left femur out and rotating it out. It allows me to get a little deeper. Extend the legs out, a little shake. Bring your right foot into the left thigh. Square off the pelvis, reach and fold. Come up, switch sides. Will extend, reach, bend your knees if you for your low back, and then fold. You'll come up, take your hands behind you. You can do the reverse plank or tabletop. I'm going to do tabletop, bent knees. Pelvis lifts, neck goes back. And chin to chest, calm down. Quick fish pose. Hands underneath your seat, you're on your elbows. Lift up, let the crown of the head touch the floor for 3, 2. Last breath. Your chin. Come down. And draw your knees into your chest. Happy baby. Grab your big toes or the outer edges of your feet. Let your knees drop down. Back to your chest, cross the right leg over the left, hips to the left, go legs to the, I'm sorry, hips to the right, legs to the left. Turn your right ear down. Gently back to center and switch it. Left leg over, hips to the left this time, legs to the right. Back to the center, draw your knees into your chest. from knees to chest, butterfly. So Supta again. And then in lieu of Shavasana today, I'm gonna do waterfall. If you would prefer to go straight to Shavasana, you can. But I like a gentle, relaxing inversion at the end of an early morning practice. It kind of helps me, I feel like it helps me focus through my day. One more breath, and then you choose either waterfall or Shavasana. Either way, you want your upper body to rest. In waterfall, you'll reach up out of strong legs, let your shoulders drop. Loosen your jaw. Rest. If you're in Shavasana, just let your breath deepen. If you're in waterfall, legs up the wall, gently bring your knees to your chest and remove the block. And then together, we'll roll to the side. Allow your head to rest on your arm and hug in. Five big breaths. And then gently help yourself up to seated. Land. Eyes shut. Long, strong posture. Hands to heart center. One long breath in. Thank you. I hope you have a wonderful day.